他得需要的，那么的点了，是你的需要的，需要的。
So, our subject matter topic of this class would be the easy path.
他的那么的点了，是要的，在把不的边界路上去见的是。
So, the author of the text was Panchen Lobsang Chögyen.
아니 지다 람리딜라 가담 슝바와 세지제 가담 람림바 세지 가담 맹아바 수미야리 디나네 가담 맹아베 슝지스
So, in the Lamrim traditions or the mind training tradition, there are three different branches. The first one is called the philosophical Lamrim practitioners, and then the philosopher, the Lamrim practitioner, and then the Shumbabachi,
Lamrimba.
Lamrimbara, and the mind training practitioner, and then the last one is
Negamba. Negamba.
see the Lamrim
Menga se tingon do king menga se.
Yes. It's like
Tela to ni do bash.
Do you know what? No, not close lineage. It's like a blessing lineage. Yes, blessing lineage. Yes.
Oh, di tati di menga ba se di ni lamri tila karsure. Nga da te lamri chires chasa.
Di lamrim di rol.
Menga ba se di.
So the blessing lineage of Lamrim normally it has it contains so like the Vajrayana practices as well.
Ta yin sa. Ta di ani ta kulung di gari gore se na ta chi ta nam ju chue yin ne sa chue yin pa ta gari chue jo ki chao gari je we ne sim je tham je ki ani dunghe se ya ta sim je tham je ki dewa tu ya ki chitu sangi ju kuban tu ki yin si ani di chitu nge chue di singi yin sambarab ji ta kunu dewa di kukuri di nge pa tu kukuri ya re si
So, before we listen to this kind of teachings, so it's important that we need to set up our right motivations. So here, this particular practice, we need to set up a special kind of motivations or intentions. So then the intention is that bodhicitta intentions. So then you have to set up motivation, something like I'm going to listen these teachings, and that actually enable me to develop bodhicitta and ultimately gain enlightenment. That is, I'm doing that for that is for sake of sentient beings. I'm doing all this for to help sentient beings. So at least, so you need to develop that kind of motivation in order to listen this teaching.
추 세야딕 지나 300톤에 누구야레스 300톤에 누구야레 제상 기부 중요 최선으로 와라 아니 천대기 나신 온도 마수마 치마 편제기 고노 지구게야레스 드네 기부 링기 최선으로 와라 아니 치매 낭신도네 아니 가르스 그래 타바 둠드기 삼베스는 뭐지 그게 알았어 근데 다 깨부친 그 쳐서 들어와라 쳐서 제주기 쓴 제마 춘제기 쓴 뭐지 그게 알았어 쳐서 쳐서 들어서야 돼 취미로지 표수는 취미인비 개발 메리스 그래서는 그 꾸는 데 줄이스 꾸는 생에 개침 브레스
So the Dharma practices are determined by how you set up your motivations or intentions. So, so for instance, the small scope practitioners, their intention or their motivation is that something they wanted to get rid of all they kind of abandon this life. They are looking for better life in the futures. So wherever they do practice, that actually brings some benefit in the future. They aim for benefit in the futures. So this kind of intention is called the small scope intention or small scope practitioners. So then the middling scope practitioners, their intention, their primary intention is that they are not actually looking future life's happiness. They wanted to get free from samsaric existence. So that will be their intentions. So when it comes to the Mahayana or the great vehicle practitioner or scope, so then their intention should be a bodhicitta. So bodhicitta is something that wanted to attain enlightened state or Buddhahood in order to help sentient being. So that's why, so since this is Mahayana practice or Mahayana text or practice, so we need to at least set up that kind of motivation.
Then I'm going to Tomba Sangye ki jinju re sin yes Tomba Sangye ki tambu tu ki du simje ki kang es che ki tu tu ki pa tu ke jin ta me cho sum tu cho sa du ni simje ki di ki chi tu sa yes tarong ba zo sangye de simje ki tu ni sangye ki kumangun tu che bres cha sang ngara zo chujo ki chao kare chi chewe ne nye la simje thamje ki kange se ya ta di dewa dhubya ki chitu samnu chi ta ane di je su chujo ki chao tine juku resi.
So if yourself consider as a Buddha followers, so then we should copy him. So like we should do exactly what he had done or he did. So then so for instance when he developed bodhicitta from the beginning, so all of this take place, or he developed bodhicitta to help sentient beings from the beginning. So then in the middle when he practiced so everything practice is oriented to bring happiness for the sentient beings. So when he become Buddha at the end, he is only thinking about welfare or happiness of the sentient being. So that's why when we do a practice, at least we should have that kind of motivation, something that we can benefit to entire sentient beings.
Chitu tamba simje thamje ki digi ki chitu dichi ki yin si labi yin rangi tunta tilab chimbo dhugu yari. Naji bija sindi rangi mao pana ranyi kibu yun ya mao pana ranyi lami kubantu ya. Ani dindi ki samtamba yin sambati kya chunju jani ani rangi kibu chimbo mebi yinbari. Di maji bija simje thamje sinna ni simje ki dhanda nyambe ku samlu chi tambari, simje ki diji la. Samlu tambari yasa, simje ki dhanda nyambe sunim chi tsagi yari. Di yasa sunim chi tsagi tu, sangyata chanju simba ki sikiri samlu tandanti. Ani rangli kibe chimbu yungu yari. Machi bache rangi tsindili nyame ba. Kiwa chi ma yapo yu yag suru chi samlu tamba yina di samlu kya chunju jani rangla kibin chimbu ragi mebari mawa bana.
So so when we develop that kind of intention, something bring welfare or happiness for the sentient beings, so when we have that kind of intention, so that also brings welfare or happiness for yourself as a personal yourself. It's not that we are we are abandoning our own welfare or happiness. So let's say if you develop a motivation, something that for personal, like wish to gain a higher rebirth in the future or have some wealth in the future. And so then to cure some sicknesses, if you engage in some sort of practices, in Dharma practices, that is really limited the intention. So this is just thinking for yourself, just one person. So if you expand that intention into entire sentient beings, so then there are numberless of sentient beings. So then it said that you will accumulate a merit as same as same number as sentient beings. That means like enormous. It's like a really lot of merits. So that's why it's better to develop something that is more beneficial. So then instead of thinking of yourself, if you include entire sentient beings in your intention, so that actually accumulates better, more. Or more merit than thinking of yourself.
Oh, this jesa. Ichu chogu chawa kar chene lamsa ma che bche samlo chita ne. Ngeti chawa di kar chigu to ra khune chito samlo tang to shembe ke samba tang to samlo ta ni. Rang khune chi tu samlu tambe ina ta samlu ti kya chun chu che. Rang la pendo meba che. Ani tinte ingri che sa shenbe ki samba yuna ta shenbe ki samba tu yabu samlu ta. Ani chawa dil chubu ina. Ani mani chik chi tambe ina lab chimbu. Simje ki tanda nyambe. Ani so so sagyari. Ranchi ko chitu mani tambe na ranchi le amare sim tindi ki kya chunju jire dubare. Tinsa na chuse ati sambe to ne kya chijun dubare.
So anytime when you begin Dharma practice or any virtuous deeds, so then it is a good practice that you should check your intention. So why you are doing that? Why you are going to do a practice? Why the reason why you are doing that? So you need to double check with yourself. And if you find there's something you're thinking of yourself, so maybe you're thinking of like curing some sort of some sicknesses. So then, so if you find that, so then you should change that. Then instead of thinking of yourself, you should include entire sentient beings in your intentions. So then if you do that, so again, so then the sentient being is numberless. So means they are numberless. So that's why if you include all of them in your intention, if you do it something for them, so then your merit will be like numerous. It's like really unlimited stuff like. So then that's why it said if you have that kind of intention, then even though if you offer a candle light to your Buddha, so that big practice becomes really powerful with that kind of intentions. So then it said that the Dharma practice is depend on how you set up your motivation. So that's why from the beginning you should set up your motivation in that large scale, so then you will accumulate more the merits.
Oh, this and that. Kulundi tat watinde kulundi kulu sangbo chiku gyer karsene ani ngarandu sem jang jan ani yabu yungri karsene phamati gi pugu pugu nasuna ngan na chuga sem pugu ti ta chuga sem sarab chiyar ba pugu kangen chesuna ani ku nam nyindi meba pugu kange seya samlu tangiri pugu dewa tuya samlu tangiri tina shi ti pasam kachiru tani pugu juga mayimba kari jene simjegi tamjegi dewa tuya Dewaji tena chi manu sambar. Simje thamje ni kange ta tena chi manu sambar. Rangi kange ta rang samnut tani. Rang kange yubana shi ta simje thamje le kange yari chesa. Kange di Tēnā chī mārū sāmbara chūyō nē, tā tī kū rā yēwār tō nē, shē chē pā sōng sē tī rā mā. Pā mā tī pūgū tī, ngā nā lē pūgū tī kāngi tī chē yīndi, pūgū nā nā rā nā nā wā rāp chī sāṁ tāng rā mā, ngā nā nā sāng pūgū tī. Tintik nele tuina sangirwa. Pugula amala, pugula tintik kuru simchiyarwa. Tina shi simchiyar tamchiyala. Samlu tana, ani simchiyar tamchiyala. Raa yewa tuina simchiyar tamchiyaka kange seyaka samlu chi kukuyarwa. Ti samlu ti tanda ni chan kukuyari. Chan suna ani kone kumbita tukuyari. Oti insa,
So, a mind that always thinking for about others' welfare and happiness is something that we can develop. For instance, when we look at a mother, so then the mother to her child, she always thinking the welfare and happiness for that child. So that is kind of like meditating on that element. So she's constantly thinking about something that can benefit their children. So then she is, because of that motivation, so she is willing to take any difficulties, anything. So for instance, if the child gets sick, she thinks if she doesn't get any solution, if she doesn't help that child and personally, she may have a intention or wish that I could have taken that sickness or the illness from that child. They will have that kind of intention, that kind of motivation, really motivation. So we can develop that something like that, similar to that mother's the intention. If you keep practicing on that. So thinking about welfare and happiness of the sentient beings, entire sentient beings, and thinking about the reason why we should develop that kind of thing. So then if you're constantly thinking about that and meditating on that, and then finally or eventually, so you are become something that, that kind of intention comes naturally to you, and you will have a similar kind of emotion or empathy as a mother to their child.
Then... nga jasa nga ranzuge kewe jawan yukdu tamba rang chigwe duanda la kewe jawan yukna pa tatu tamba chu jebe suru chisige re chu mara chi pebe na shenla chimbara chi tani chu jebe suru chi mune jene ta rang chugu ka samu tambara ba rang chugu ka kewe nga chi do ni chēmē pī māne tāng chēvarabhā, o tī yīnsu chū sū rūg mēvarī, chēndī kī chītū tī sām tāng parabhā, o tī yīnsā, nēni pātā tū chū chēvē sūrī chī chē, ngō nē tī chū lī māchīn bā chē, o tī chī yārī, chēsā ngā rā rū chū chēvā tī chū tī chū lī rū bā chī. Di samtangu, di insang, di kunung diris, ta di jidang kyechim buris.
So, for instance, if you make an offering of light or candlelight to Buddha, so if you are wishing to gain some benefit for yourself, and then if you engage in that kind of act, offering a light to Buddha, so that act is, looks like, that act itself looks like dharma practice. So that's something, then if you make an offering to Buddha, that is, we consider, it's normally it's considered as a dharma act. So since you have that kind of intention is something that brings a benefit for yourself, so that act doesn't become dharma at all. So that is not a dharma practice. So dharma practice is totally depend on how you think about it, how you set up your motivation, and how you think about the the motivation or the intention of that practice?
Oh, that is that is the name of the Kuranzu Yerba. The name of the Siruchis.
I guess everybody has text. Do you have text?
Di mare.
La.
Di lamda.
Al di tiro. Si yujur kunsul. So I'm just going to use root text. If you have root text, that's fine. You don't need to. You don't need the book.
It has root text in it. Okay. Okay. Tambula nis, tungung all a chitter java, tundum chitter java, singing duga. Then a tambula, chonga chesums, a singing tinsitilla, choas, nguj, and juice, jasumiari. Then a ne, that choroati is gere. Ah, ye tunginesu, that
subject my stamsha. So it's on page number 27. So Ramesh just went through the outlines. If you look at it, says so it has two sections. Okay, from that it has two sections. It's on the paragraph, the second one, first one, second, third paragraphs and third line. It has two sections: how to rely upon a spiritual teacher, the root of the path, and once relying, the stages of mental training. So then the first one has two subsections, and just go from here. Okay, tungyung or chida labsu means how to train during the sessions, meditation sessions, and how to train during the post meditative sessions. The first one has three. And jorwa tangbo, jorwa means the actions, the actual session, how to align thoughts.
Ah.
I call it deeds, conclusions. Okay, this okay. How to relying in thoughts, yes. And the training in faith. Jorwa juksumra. Training in faith, the root, the practice, recollecting the spiritual teacher, kindness and not okay.
Jorwadi,
how to rely on deeds. Jorwa jiksum, let's. Jorwa jiksum is like how to do in the beginning, like and then the actual practice or the conclusion. Oh yeah, I got it now. Yes, yes, preparation, the actual session. Yeah, so conclusions. Okay.
Yeah, that is. That in a that Joala Joe Chu drew Sia Chiari, Dinamri Kangalore, Dinala Joe Chu drew the Yi Dungine Society, Tati Karasuri Negan chidur chasi, negan di tembari, yidungi ne su se de negan di tembari. Negan chidur chasi, kusun tungi ten tamba se adi, yidungi ne su se de, yidungi ne se adi, ara su su lamri kum nyeji inu lamri kum sagi ne di. Ne tambu dile, kusun tungi ten tamba se adi, tembe ku chi je. Ani tuanbe sungu jeje, ni tuu jeje, kusung tuji ten chamba si, tenje chi chamba si tu kusung tuji tu tenji. Meganti chitur che sani ta zangma su, ani tine kusung tuji ten ti, kuyi ten, sungi ten chi, tuu ten ti keti pa cham, kusung tuji ten chamba si ati tiri.
So now on page number 28, the last paragraph, it says my preparation. In an agreeable place, right? So Nidungi Nesu, agreeable place. So there are six, there are six preliminaries in every Lamrim practice in the beginning. So then the here is said in the agreeable place. Agreeable place means it actually describes what kind of place you should choose. So then the place should be something that's comfortable for you, and you need to arrange or set up an altar that actually represents this object that represents the body, speech and mind of Buddha. So you can have a statue of Buddha, and then the text that is a scripture Buddha, and then the kusung the tukde kharishao chude, and you can have a stupa as Buddha's mind, the represents Buddha's mind.
Ngani choba yome ba yome ji kuben de vrasham ba se di dile choba chem choba kharisham ne di choba metorab tinde ani ji sheserab tinde ani ji yin chobsene churab tinde o ta su su chaba yo meshi kuben zebra shamba sya ti chaba shamya ti che.
So then in front of the holy objects, so then we need to set up offerings. So that can be offering any something that you have, so something that you can afford. So like you can set up flowers, you can set up fruit, and at least you can set up the water bowls. So in front of all three objects, arrange them in really nice manners. Like.
Kusun tu yarba te kusun tu duga ati dula chobara chisham choba kande chisham ne tisham choba kusun tu jitenda ma choba yome pa leba choba tisham chasunga ata dine ani lyudu ne gedam jolam kande kwe ne kesim keba chinyunga ne kyamdu simgi chawa sayate. Tene di tengan mate zangma su chasuna, zangma su tene chubara chisham. Te chasuna ani tengan mate ani lyudu neb gedam sidi dulu gedi karasana ani di lyunamna chudun sayache. Digan la ujungus jena gedri. Odi ane kandi kune, digane junumdi yabuchiku ane gyamdu simji chawa asetri.
So then once you set up a proper place, so the place has to be clean, and then set up altar, the objects that represents body, speech, and mind of Buddha, and set up all the offerings in front of them. So once you set up a proper place, So then you can sit on a cushion, really comfortable cushion, and then you can engage in the posture, meditation, gesture, you know, sitting on this gesture. Here is normally we say seven Virochana posture. So here it says eight. So eight means there it added actually one more practices. It called the breathing meditations. So when you add a breathing meditation to seven Virochana, it adds up eight the practices.
So then
you do Tamdo Simge practice refuge and bodhicitta, develop bodhicitta.
Jamdu keba chena ni lama la kyesu chewa, sangye la kyesu chewa, chewa la kyesu chewa, kintu la kyesu chewa, sigiriba. Jamdu che. Ani simgi che. Simgi se ati, simje tundu, simje tamje tundu, sangye chukupan toba chewa nyambati. Ti simgi sigiri. Sangye chota choji chonam la, chanju padu tani kyesu che, sidu jamdu che. Tāk jēsū kīpē sōnam kīn rūla pīnjā sāngyē tūpē shūs chē, sīm gī chē.
So, if you wanted to do extensive, elaborate refuge practice, you can recite all them in individually, sort of like. You can say, I go for refuge to Buddha, I go for refuge to Dharma, and Sanghas, you can say it out loud and do in practice, engage in that kind of practice. So then the bodhicitta. So bodhicitta. So then you need to develop bodhicitta afterwards. Jambro semke the kind of chevrsa semke. Jambro the sangal chavse chol chavse kundi chavse malagura. Ani the. Oh, dagi chinsu kibe. And you can recite bodhicitta prayers. This is a well-known phrase in Tibetan. It says, "I go for refuge." I go for refuge Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha until I gain enlightenment. Whatever I accumulate merits, I'll dedicate to sentient beings. It's a really short one. There's a well-known prayer in Tibetan, so you can recite that to practice bodhicitta.
Oh, that is that is Chaps and draw us at the Rangi Samluti any Kunjo chose Fatania Tele. Chaps and draw us at the Kapti Kunjo Sumche. T chose Palo T chose draw at the Chaps and draw cigarette. Drutu the caressine Kunjo Sum the each of it, each of the average chunsona.
So, the refuge practice is that you're placing total trust in three objects of refuge. So then there's sometimes we have different phrases like go for refuge and taking refuge. So then all of these are an intention, a thoughts. So that if your mind get close to these three objects of refuge, so then you're taking refuge. So then it's believing in these three objects of refuge. So they are save me, they can protect me. So if you have that kind of, if you place that kind of trust in all these three objects of refuge, that is taking refuge and going for refuge.
Lama dan sanje kunjo singe ti ral lamdu na nye ti bari kyap tumba posi lam tu nye ti la kyap tumba posi ran du ngune kyam nye ti us kyam nye ti ni sanje ki tuen shaba ki lam ti ki tu us jubi yare jesa kyap tumba posi ati kyap ti chukun josha ditamba putila kyaptamba bus ti sangye shabur tambu sangye chumde dege ne ngana zula tambe chuti tambarwa jambe chuti tambarwa tambe yasa tambe chuti karare sene kyap kyaptri kyaptamba bu segete sangye le kyaptun bapu sikyari, kyaptun bapu sikyari kyapti karishasun chöti isha. Chöttun bapu di sangye rima. Dine, ta sangye le kyaptun bapu sikyari, sangye le, sangye kutun shabakin lamdila, ni cichitu, deba cichitu chiyatila, ni sangye le kyapsun dhru sikyari. Aranzu kane kyapsun dhru siya di dhomba dhamdhu maase. Ani sangye di, sangye ki sung shaba di luwa dhamdhu meba. Sangye ki sung bati nipe chi chema yinba, luwa meba rupchi deba jesu na. Ani kyap dhomba puse, sangye li kyap dhomba puse, kyapsun dhruwa sikere, kyap dhomba puse, kyapsun dhruwa, kyap dhomba puse chema yinba. Kyab di dunye mitruba, kyab di dunye di jesu, kyab dunbapu di jesu, di sung shaba di nyamsu lana, ni luwa mebarab chi yiji ki deba jesu na. Ani sangyele kyab sundruwari, sangyele kyab sundruzi di diris.
So then how they protect us? So then the actual protector is the Dharma itself. So Dharma is the one that actually gives us protections. So if you do Dharma practice by ourselves, that practice protects us from all unnecessary the sufferings. Yeah? So then the Buddha is like a teacher or instructor. So Buddha is the one that actually gives us all these instructions, how to practice, how to overcome your sufferings and so on. So then the Buddha acts like a teacher. Teacher or instructor. So then the in order to believe in the teachings of the Buddha, so then we need to believe in Buddha first. So if we have a strong belief in Buddha, so then we consider him as a valid person or reliable person or the reliable source of happiness. So then more likely we will carry out his instructions, his teachings. So then, going for refuge or taking refuge means believing in his instructions and believing in him as an instructor. So someone's believing in him that person or the Buddha will never deceive us. So whatever he gives teachings, that is something worthwhile to undertake or carry out as a practice. So if you have that kind of belief, that is taking a refuge. It's not that if you reciting lines and the prayer of refuge practice is not a refuge practice. Refuge practice is something you placing a trust or belief in these three objects of refuge.
Siji tu teba chene, ti nyamsu lemba tila, ani choli kyapsu dhosi gyari. Ani pina, tomba sangye ki tiba chiya chay chuyamari, kiawa pisum tsu pa chesi, tīpa jīgyūyā mārī, tīpa tāmane pāṅkurī, gyāvā tāmane tūkurī sēni sūmbarvā, tīnā shīñi chēni gyāvā tāmane tūkadū. Tīpa tāmane pāṅkadū chēbayi nā, anī tīni chōli gyāpsu tūsī gārī. Tī chēsū nā, tīgī gārīlē gyāpgurī, ngā sūnī gyāpgurī yārī. Ngā sūnī gyāpnyē tī, chö singe di yinpare, dipun ke tupi chö di, yabuchi jaiso na, ni ngensung li kyabu yari. Domba sangye ki lamdun na shabati, maje bache, rangi kichö matru na, rang ya thandab mebi yinpare. Ta yin isa, chö ki nyamne jie, chö li kyabsun rose tu, chö la nyamne jia ti, zo tiri. Chūla yī jīgī tēpa chāni ñamne chāsūna, anī chūla kyapsu dhruvāti ngūne jīgīyā rīs.
So then taking refuge in Dharma or go for refuge in Dharma means that once you receive instructions from Buddha, so Buddha will say, don't engage in misdeeds or tend non-virtuous actions. So he will say, if you take that as serious and take that as a practice, so if you do it, so when you engage in all those avoiding 10 non-virtuous action and misdeeds, so that is taking refuge in Dharma. So you're believing in him and doing it and carry out that practice as is instructed. So that is taking refuge in Dharma. So otherwise, if you do exactly opposite or against that instructions, so then you will suffer and then you will and have like a lot of difficulties in the future. So that is we are taking protection or refuge from that possibility experiences.
Oh, jesa ani ngarandu ngesu tu kya di dibele dibasan ki gyare tīpa pāṅsūna āni ngāsūnti kīgī mēpari. Chasā tīpa tīla kārēsini ngūnzu mīgī vācchū sēchūpa. Sōk chūpa, mācīmpa līmpa, lōparīmpa, sūmche. Āni tū tāma cīgīchū ngā kēsī shīn lū ngā kī tūyīn sēchī tīrī. Chasā ngāsūnti ñāvātā yītātā tōntu sūmla kēyātī kārīch kīgī ārēsini ne tibba chebala tini kikiyari. Tibba mache na ngensung sumla kiya mebari. Chesan ta, ani tombega sumba na chi tibba chikyuya mari. Kewa tukuri sumba na. Shi chani susu lalengla tibba chungu ne paan katu che. Kewa tamo ne tup kandu chebayi na ani ngensung li kiya mebari. Tini, tīgī rāngī ñamne tīgī, rāngī ñasūngi kiamñi tī rāngī ñamne tīgī pari. Rāngī tīlī tī ñamne tī mēnā, rāngī ñasūngi kiamñi tī sāngyē kīyā tēngā kē mē pari. Sāngyē kī tēngā yūna rāngī ñamne chē mōgō pachē, sāngyē kī tēngā rāb chū yūna sīmchē thamchē sāngyē kī tēngā chā kīrvā. Sāngyē lī tsāvā yārī, anī thāpshī yārī. Ani ti isa, ati ngarandu nyamne machane ngarandu thariya mebari. Chasa ta nyasun le thariya le thabdi tipa punya kewa tubya di imbari. Kewa tubna ngadul hami kubhan tubyari. Tipa jesuna nyasun le kikari. Ta nyasun le thariya ke thabdi karire sene tipa punya. Kewa tupiya tiriyasi. Ti chesu na, ani chö kunju ke, ngon su kyamnya ti chö kunju tiriyambari. Rangon su kyamnya ti rangi nyamne tiri. Rangi nyamne tiri, ani rangya kyabari. O chesa rangi nyamne machani kyabgaya mevari.
So the all of our sufferings and lower realm rebirth experiences due to our negative karmas. So then if you create a negative karma, so that negative karma brings unfavorable consequences. So in order to abandon or in order to eliminate all this negative quality, so then Buddha teaches us that we should abandon 10 non-virtuous actions. So then the 10 non-virtuous actions are stealing. There are 10 non-virtuous actions, right? So the 10 non-virtuous actions, I'm not going to go like each of them, okay? So like three physical the non-virtuous action and three the verbal four verbal negative actions and she three mind, three mind. So then if you abandon all these actions, so then you will not suffer sufferings, you will not suffer the lower ends, the experience of lower ends. So then if you abandon all of these 10 non-virtuous actions, you will not suffer. So that is the actual protections. So if you practice, so that becomes your actual protections. So Buddha would not able to help you and give you siddhis or give you all these realizations. So then we need to do it by ourselves. We need to abandon. So then the Buddha cannot do that. So if Buddha could do that, so then all the sentient beings would have already attained the Buddhahood, or them enjoying their happiness. So it's not that Buddha is incapable, or Buddha has a shortage of any ability to help sentient beings. Buddha has a great compassion. Buddha has great compassion, and he has a strong intention or wish to help sentient beings from the sufferings. He has that. So the only matter is this: we are not capable. We are not ready for that. So that's why we suffer. So that's why the actual dharma becomes the dharma practice becomes our actual protectors.
Oh, tene sanje kunjo ti member keva te tsungbe inje member keva ti ki ne tele to ala ti chegures lam dinang yerwa member keva ti ki ane a me ti da ti sagure sirwa ane me ti chu kunjo te chibare ne yo di kindu kunjo se te jasa nebachi nele to ala ani member keva chilete tene member keva ti me ten sha me che sha ti rang sa ani ji tele ji guma chi nyer bu me sa da da me sa ye tyun jam da usule me di chelu me ba sa ya ti ne yo ti ji gur ba ani ti sum ti member keva ti Sanje Kunjo Tandrawai. Sanje Kunjo the member Keva Tandrawai. Chu Kunjo the Me Tandrawai. Kindu Kunjo the Neo Tandrawai.
So we have a classic analogous how we see, how we consider two objects as personal protectors. So that is. Buddha is like a great reliable physician, and then the dharma is like a medicine, the medicine, and then the sanghas are like nurse. So then the Buddha as a doctor, so when they diagnose our physical problems, sickness and stuff like that, so they will give you some, they will put you on medication. So if you take that medicine, so then you will cure from that sicknesses. Similar like that, so Buddha is the one who actually gives us, you know, diagnoses our problems. It tells us, you know, how to eliminate them and how it occurs to us, in our, you know, how do we experience all the sufferings, and the way how we how we can develop, how we can eliminate all these sufferings. He will give us all the instructions. So then if you apply all this instruction as a personal practice, so then you will be able to free from suffering, similar like taking a medicine. So then the sanghas are like a nurse, so they actually help us during our journey to enlighten.
Member kevati ani ne di chitu men di sagure me te shabti masena ni member kevagi chea merba sangye gi ti bapo kevatu se at mache che te bina ani nge sone tha du mare kare se na member kevati ne di chitu men di sagure ani ani karasugure, chodin ti chigure siddhu chamba, ti manyin bache, ani manyina, ani karuk, nedile thagi marwa. O ti nashita, ani tomba sanjige, me ti rang maase na, tomba sanjige karasare, me ti rang maase na, ani memba kheba digi chiha kageya marwa. Oti dinashi, ani tomba sangye ge sung shabati, ani rangi nyamne che na, ani ne dili thagir pe na, nye sung le thawala kharche gure, tibun kitu che gure es. Oti sung shabati, tibun kitu che su na, ani nye sung le thagir iti ma che na, thagir marwa. Oti mebe yinsa ta, ngone di aranju ngone kemye di ngos kemye di chukunjo di yaris
so similar
ngos
like
kemye di neba di ngos kemye di member di karasa me di ba me te nye di di
so similar like a doctor when they prescribe medicine to a patient. If the patient doesn't take medicine, so then he will not, that individual may not cure from that sicknesses. So similar like that, so if he takes, and then they also, doctor, they give some guides, so how to eat and what to avoid, and he will give some instructions in order to cure that sicknesses. If you follow all these instructions and take medication and as is, and the doctor instructed, so then you will be able, you will cure from that sicknesses. Similar like that, so Buddha will give you instruction how to eliminate your sufferings. So then he will say abandon all the non-virtuous actions and engage in more virtuous wholesome actions. He will say that. If you don't abandon non-virtuous actions, so then you will never experience happiness. You will constantly suffer. So that's why, so then if you follow that instruction and abandon all the non-virtuous actions and carry out all these virtuous actions, so then you will be able to free from yourself from sufferings.
Oh, teacher, then never the ne nele travela neyo tigi chigi ku me tunju tunju le treya ane chi nayo digi jigi ji kulabe member gi nga shin tu pe rigu chu ya tu se yabu chi je ma ni na ko ne le thag mar ba che sa gin du kun jo se ti kyab tu pe ta jo se ya ti me sa ya lu jo chi ni ti ne ba ti je gu ya re karasa neyo dike me tunju tunju le teya me ani khala masa kon le ste khala masa kon le ino khala masa kon le te ko karasa se ne te ko ya ne se ne te ko ya ani chwe den chi ta tu su neyo di chi kiri ba tu su je ne neyo ge neyo ge leba na shi che su ne ani ku nele tugi arba oti ta chi pare ta kindu kun jo se ati.
So the sanghas are like nursing assistants. So they when we get sick, really sick, then we become weak, so then we need an assistant
so assistant, so like someone can remind us when to take the medicine, and they will give us medication on time, and they will they give us nutrition food on time. So when we need that kind of help when we are sick and weak, helpless. So similar like that. So then the when we to practice, so then the during the practice we need to get some help from Sangha members. Sangha members, they actually reminds us on time, so what needs to be done instead of that. So then there's, we need to, as a patient in hospital, so we need to respect, we need to pay some respect to nursing the nurses or the nursing assistants. So similar like that, so we need to pay respect to the Buddha Sangha member as well in regard for that reason.
Tene ngarandu ge sanje kada geba mambu che yari jebe tu se ya ngar che shab tu su sem shune te mar ya dag dab che yari ane diksha che yari bene chanju sem tibo to je shin do mese ba tene chanju sem be ke shin kang se ji ne ba ni chanju sem kum so ne tibo to je shin do mese ba tu su अने ताया ये बोले जैसा नरसा शब्द तो सुनो गैसिम चे फिर नतीबसा शब्द यू नती गैसिम चे ती ताबे ची तो अने चंचुग सिम को यहाँ ती ताबे ची तो घर जने ती ताबे रंगे नर चेवे ने बट ताबे ची तो मनेरे ची तो ने दिशारे टुगेरे अने सांगे ताजा के तुम्बे छेरे बतिंडे चूसने दिशा रे टुकेरे जैसा अगर जेब तो सुनिया तिबा शाया ती सांगे के सुंबरे तिबा शाह सुना अने तिबा मासा बतां तिबा माचे बतां तिबा साने ताप शाउतम जेब निपुती किबु तंबनी सियारे किबु तंबनी तिचियारे तिबजाने मासेंगे चियारे ती किबु तंबा तिबसाने अनि तिबले बे जोसिम चेनि शाउतम चिंगे चियारे ती किबु तंबा सियारे जसा ngalsa shabdu su ne ani dag bet shabachiya yaris
so then when we look at our own situation, for instance, we may think I may have accumulated a lot of negative karmas, so then the maybe it's impossible to purify or purify them. So then if you have that kind of discouragement thoughts, so then you shouldn't feel discouraged, because the good quality about the negative karma is there's something we can purify them. There's a way to purify all the negative karmas. So then the way we purify negative karma is something that we should practice. We should practice dharma. The best way to purify our negative karma is to develop practice or develop bodhicitta. So in the guide to the Bodhisattva way of life, in that text it said that the bodhicitta, there's no such a negative quality that will not purified by bodhicitta. Bodhicitta acts like kalpa ending fire that actually destroys entire universe at the end. Similar like that, bodhicitta practices that kind of power, so they can actually purify any type of negative karmas. So there's no a negative karma they can actually not purify by the bodhicitta. So then
मन मन ला
Manohar. And you can in order to purify negative karma, so you can recite name of Buddhas, you know, so Om Mani Mani, and name of some deities. So if you do that, you know, aim to purify your negative qualities or negative karmas, so that practice becomes purification practice. So then, so you need to think about it.
Shadum Chegugari, Shadum Chedita, Shabagutti, any Chita, Janju Semquia, Chambata, Nijita, Janju Semquiatus, so embry. Litine Sanges, Sumjutsung, like a Chenjuya, and a Shalajan, Chimbataya, and a Gunjula Chuba Pier, to so Kangulo, Tibatavish, Tablum to Viari. Tibet tabe chito, chuba pugache. Tibet tabe chito, simjeli chimbata. Oh, tinde chevina. Any tisha de duguere, any marisabe tibetu sutan duguere. Oh, dear, sir.
So the, and Buddha said that negative quality or negative karma can be purified. So if you believe in him, so then we really don't need to discourage, we don't need to feel bad about our negative karma. If once we something that we have done, okay, we don't need to feel bad about our negative karmas, so that can be purified. And also in the sutra it said that there are two types of identifiers, kind of two types of noble persons. So one noble person is something that never create or never engaged in negative karmas or the misdeeds. So then the another noble person is something that so engage in purification practice. So then they with great remorse or regret about their actions. So then these are the two noble person identified in sutras. So someone who had never had that done any negative, and someone who is engaging in purification practice. So these are two noble person. And then the when it comes to a purification practice, you can practice. So there are it said in the sutra, it said that reciting the name of the Buddhas, you know, some particular Buddhas, so then that can purify the negative that have been accumulated from eons and eons. So it's like in, you know, that stock of negative can be purified just reciting a name of Buddha, something like that. So then also the Jetsun Kapa's in his personal case, Jetsun Kapa's case, he engaged in 35 confession Buddha purification practice in order to purify his negative karmas. So then there are other many practices, like if you develop love and compassion and bodhicitta and practicing generosity and giving something to somebody and making an offering to Buddha, all of this practice can be purification practice if you have the right mindset.
Ah, that is ane ta kyab se ade pena so chupon so na ne sungi tungeli kyabare nanan jo so chupat pan so na so chuna Nesung le tungeli kigirba, Nesung le kigirba. Soju pasuna, Nesung le tungeli kiva. Kura kyaviati yari soji pan so na nge sung du ngeli jek ber ba soji pan bala ten nge sung du dugi yer so ma jan ani ti ji gi nge sung le kya de ka gi yer ba kyap se ya de chö gi kyap se ya de ti bun gi to kya wa tu ti pa pan so na ani kare le kya ber nge sung le kya ber ani kiawa trup shabatigi tenru la ya kiawa chigari tenru la kiyati kiawa ki kiyaku gari nyesun la kiyati tipa ki kiyari ya tenru hlata mei kubantu yati kiawa trupu yari kiawa ki chigari chasa tipa pung kiawa trup suna ani nyesun la kiyaku mundu la mei kubantu la ya ndohar chigi yare. Oti insa, kyab yadi tiri, kyab se yadi, susu nyamlengi susu ya kyab kuru mishu chigi. Susu nyamlengi machib che, sanjegi ya kyab yachi zani mevri. Sanjegi lamdu nashabdi, rangi chubsuna, rangi ya kuala chutu yarba. Sanjegi kyab yadi, lamdu nashabdi, sanjegi kyab yadi.
So, the way in which Dharma protect us is that something, if you abandon the killing, so killing, taking others' life, sentient beings' life. So if you don't abandon that, if you engage in killings, so that killing and the result of that killing, we will take rebirth in lower realms. So if you abandon that, act of killing, so then that act of killing, abandoning that act of killing, that action, that virtuous act as protects us from lower realm experiences. This is how the Dharma practice protect us from lower realms. So then also, if you engage in virtuous, wholesome virtuous actions, then and making an offering and so forth. So that actually creates positive karma. So then the positive karma, result of positive karma is a higher rebirth. So they could be in human realm or God and demigod. So you can experience that. So then that actually, having that, you know, having that power or having that ability to take rebirth in higher realm is actually protecting us from the lower realms. So that's why, so when you abandon all this negative quality, that actually protects us from lower realms experiences. If you accumulate some merit, that also protects us from our experience of lower realms.
Jamduche, tene singirva. Ta kesim keba jin yungon e jamdu singi jawa sa. Ta simgi se hati. Simje tamje gudun da sangi yukoban toba sho nyamba tile simgi se gare. Ta tile simje ki te watu biyata. Ani kange seya ge chitu sanji ju kova toba shios. Tuku yin, achiaba yinna ta karasu gure simgi esi gare. Owa di yin sa, ta simgi seya te, jamdu simgi seya te te imbari, jamdu seya te, jisunga.
So that is how to practice refuge. So then the next is bodhicitta. So bodhicitta is intention or wish that helps sentient beings from their suffering, helping them from get rid of their sufferings. So that kind of intention is called the bodhicitta. Any questions? Do you have any questions so far?
Yeah. If you do an action like
make an offering, pray before you eat, or but you don't actively set a motivation? Is that what?
This is when I call the chebarabu pu kalamasungal chebarabu pu cheba in a and the mixegi and a kulun the majibaina dig the carres was a chebarabu.
I did mixegi chinmen a tambu ya shoger lantune chigi simjig tundukazi simjig tiki chitu netari. Chubala soba chigi in some barbicina, digi and digiaris. Cup dile majune Tarashoget, dignitary, same jig digi chitu. Chubata, ne catch your gun, new chigi in some barbici. Debug punk and chigi in some barbici juna. Nitty, that's digiaris.
Just crongy dita, gavat, demeva in a gavat in the carrivis or carrivis. So, I'm just kind of suggesting that if you are not able to track that motivation when you engage in some sort of virtuous actions, right? So you can set up motivation in the morning, early in the morning, when as soon as you get up. So think about, you know, think about that. Think something that's set up a motivation that say today I'm going to help sentient beings. I will do something for sentient beings. If you have that intention in the early in the morning, first day in the morning, so then the rest of your day becomes virtuous actions. You may not have like set up motivation at the moment when you do these actions, but that is actually covered from the beginning morning.
Tene ti gab dili yang chigi yang samdo tangyo gyamne yabu yaris. Ne ten su ne ti samdo tangurwa. O ti yinsa tene top chewa yaris.
So it is a good practice if you could set up intention and the purpose of your actions before each of your virtuous act. So that will be more powerful, much better.
Oh, the Chida Dari Kubachimbine Shindalegara Chimbine Simjig Kanga Seagi to do somebody of China Legacy Sati the Simjer of Chimbache Legacy Sati Kanga Yarba Kanga Seayare Legacy Sati Rangi, Jinji, Pamasin, Tigiar, Chitan Simje Tamje, Jinji, Pamasiati, Rigiarva, Tinsan Legacy Gachine, Netari, Tinji Pamek, Tinian, Jagarich, to be in some sort of chevine, some sambu gibri. Nick Chig Legacy at the Ku, Chidan Legacy at the Kulung Mating Surgery. In a Tinig Samlotan Sunuku. Kewalan juga juga ya re. Adi insan ani sem sampu kebar ba. Oh tu so. Kari jene kot. Yungu kari cichane ni semje kiti kiti tu insan samlut tau yang doa ti cina duba ti cina. Ani kalaj sene. Ani semje kiti kiti tu. Kalas selan lonce ni. Ni chubapu wekewatis. Ani simje tamjel tindigi. Chubasambul longyu juju ingusho. Sadun sambul longyu juju ingusho. Ngaranzu kala sambu sakyuyari. Di sawesite, ani kala zane menyege ta nyawa yita tundru yari. Mi jitene, ani togugu pumte mambu yari tusuya. And the Manduna Shinki Sella no Juju and show some the Tampa, you know. And the Kala said to give up truth to me, same some gave it.
So, and also we can transform
our daily activities into your virtuous actions. For instance, when you go to work, so then the your co-workers and bosses and all these people are sentient beings, part of our mother sentient beings. So when you go to work, so you can think that when I go to work, I wish help sentient beings. I'm going to help sentient sentient beings. So if you set up that kind of motivations, when you get to the work, so when you work, all of this work becomes virtuous actions. So in general, our work and this, if we do something without any particular intentions, so that action is called neutral actions. So then we as in a daily basis, we engage in that type of actions many times, neutral actions. So then they are not neither virtuous or the non-virtuous. So they are just neutral, they are just nothing. So then if you set up that kind of motivation from the beginning, the day, so that all of this action normally is neutral, so you can transform them into positive actions. So then the when you eat, make an offering, so then you can develop bodhicitta. So when you are eating, sort of like, so you can think of like there are many sentient beings, there are lack of food, they don't have an opportunity to enjoy that type of food. We are having really good food in this country. So then the hell realm sentient beings, you can think of them, they are constantly hungry, and the animal realms and hungry ghost realm and so forth. So you can think of their difficulties while you are eating. So wish them to enjoy your food, similar as your food, you know, in any time. So then even in this world, so there are many people do not get their enough food. So there's, you know, starving, sort of that. So you can think of them and make some wish or prayer them to enjoy as your food, you know, in the future. So if you do that, that is actually act of bodhicitta. So then even though you're eating like normal food as ordinary actions, so that can actually also transform into virtuous actions by doing that, having that kind of intention.
Is there a difference between the motivation and then the dedication? For instance, when we're in class and we say the dedication, so should we be saying the dedication in the morning throughout the, you know, for the actions of the day?
This is the Korang itanda di kulung chue di ta ngwa jawe ngwa keba kari yores ani shoge kulung di jodi nyam ngwa de phajap shane nima tirin khaji di ngwa de patang ngel ba dap shane digre wesi wor
ade ji da de sum de sabe ke wa se jere ba ya ngwa ya di ya re se shoge ne nge tari ke wa sa simba ta sa ba ku wa ta sa simba ta sa ba ku wa tem je simje gu tun tu sanje ju ku ma ta be ku ru sho se ngwa je ne di ge ya re se ngwa di ga ju je ne di ge ya re se ani di ngwa di ji je ne ga ju je ne ngwa di je ne ni ya bu ya re se
kulun ju ya da ngwa di ke ba yo ma ro ma ro se
kulun ju ya da ngwa le ke ba ya re se ga re se kulun ju ya di ngā tārī ngā gāpsu yāpū chī chī kī, sīm chī kī tī chī kī tūpī, sīm chī kī kāngā sēyā kī chī tū, ngā bē chū ngā kārī sū kūrē, tīpā pūyā tā kēwā tūpīyā, kāngā chī nū chī kī yī sāmiyā, chī kī yī sāmiyā tī kūlō tāmbā rī sī. Ngā sēyā tī shīng kēpā chī nī yā kūrīyā chī rī sī. Sanje ju kubhan toba sho, tala tene sanje ju kubhan toba sho se na, di ngua ta malam nigari giriba.
Zera ju gorbe,
ngua che zera ju gorbe. Ngua la zera gorbe, malam la zera gogu yamare. sanje ji kuban toba sho senam myonam re je khu ka ge sam da yam re tari nge ge wa dile te ne ni sanje sim je gi tun sanje ji kuban toba sho senam ngwa re ge re
so you can practice both in the morning if you want. So you can do you can set up intention. At the same time, you can practice dedication practice. So that dedication practice would be like, you can think of like whatever you have accumulated merits until now from beginning. So I will dedicate it for something. You should do that. So in general, the intention, motivation, and the dedication has these are two different separate practices. So the intention is more like a wish, you know, making a wish. So you wish to do something. So you wish to help sentient beings. You wish to obtain the enlightened state, sort of like that. So you're making a wish. And then the dedication is you're offering something for some reason. So for instance, if you have accumulated some sort of merit, so here we are using a substance. There's no substance for in the motivation. So when we set up motivation, there's no substance. There's nothing we are using, nothing. We're not making an offering. And the dedication practice is that whatever you have accumulated, that merits, we are using that merit as a substance and making an offering to a higher field, was, you know, Buddha. So then you are asking in return your enlightened state and so forth. So this is a difference in the motivation and the dedication.
Yeah. Okay.
Isn't it more powerful to actually do something to help another sentient being than to think about it?
Yes.
And plan for it?
Tapena chashana ya mela chik chego 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 den de sam lo jang sam den de cheba le miji la phang ngune khor sinje thamje la phang ngune khor pha phen do chene ya ga yo mare wesi gi do
a chego chego sam ne sem sam bu ke bari chego phen do chego sam ba ni ne a sem sam bu ke bari zo de sem di re sem sam bu ke te ane ngune pendo jene ya pendo jene shenda gi kare su gre pendo jela sem sambu yeben keba ya maris gashe omme tu jene pendo jya yung gre gashe chadang gon tu jene pe pendo jya yung gre is dine sem sambu jene ni ani pendo jebe ne yaushu dine sem sambu jene pendo jigo samne sūnā pātumē pā sāgirī, kārī sūnā sāmbā sāna sādāna miyā sāng, sāmbā ngēnā sādāna miyā ngēn sīyā tī chēnē. Ngō sū pēntō chēpālā, tsam tsam shētāngu ngī chēyā yārī, tsam tsam chāpē ngī chēyā yārī, tsam tsam chī rāngi ngē lā rā pā tīndi chē, trā lā rā pā tīndi chī chūrī chēnē, tīndi chēyā yārī. Tīndi chēpī nā,
So, you know, the wish or intention versus engaging actual actions. Okay, actions. So then so there are different things we need to look at. You know, helping other, you know, doing something physically or, you know, actively doing something to somebody is not necessarily it's a virtuous act. You can help someone to deceive somebody, or you can do it with your attachment or aversion. You can help somebody with aversion and attachment. Right? So if you don't have the right motivation, that can cause problems. Right? Problems. So the motivation is the crucial main thing. So if you have a right motivation, right thing, so helping to other. So then if you do out of that kind of motivation, so that will definitely beneficial, much, much more, you know, beneficial. If you don't have that kind of mindset, right mindset, sort of like, that can cause, you know, problems.
Yeah.
We're going through preliminaries. Is there a big difference between saying them versus thinking them?
Sanji chota tsuyi tsuna janjiba tani kiyos chi ku taban dungriba. Dungri di ku samlu ke yamari, ku di yamari. Samlu yuena, ni samlu yuena sanji chota tsuyi tsuna nasi. Mandu ne sanji li kiyosun ruya di, chu li kiyosun ruya di samlu di yuena, mandu ne di kiya resi. Zu di kiamru siya di simgi tuni chi ku kiya resi. Ani kiamru pika ngāne tuyane samlo mātāna, ni ti rajuyo ti chibare rōrēs.
So the verbally action is not really important, I'm saying. So mental is the more important. So then the saying out loud is not necessary if you have, you know, if you do it in the mentally, practice all this practicing mentally. Like if you play sutra in audio tape, right? So that is kind of like a sound. That is a sound, but it's not, there's nothing, this is not a practice or not a practice. If you act like that, so then that doesn't become a practice. So the mental is more important than the actions. So then if you do verbally with intention, you know, mentally, so that will be more beneficial. For instance, if, even though if you're just playing an audio and a mantra audio, so then if someone hear that, so that by hearing that sound can remind them a practice. So you can do that too. So it totally depends on how you think about how you set up your motivation in the beginning.
Sorry. Sometimes as a householder we have problems with animals, ants, bees, so forth. Rinpoche mentioned the non-virtue killing. And sometimes for health or safety we have to consider how do we solve this problem. Can
Rinpoche
give some advice on dealing with
this? The first thing is that the food is not good. The food is not good.
Tisha Chia Yaris Gati Tindi chebi yana, shadum chea yari, shadum chea kuru yari. Shadum macha na, nyebati, ko te te girwa.
So, yes, when it comes to that kind of situation, so we need to look really careful. For instance, if you don't take care of that problem in the beginning, that can actually expand, that can become major problems in the future, right? So by having that intention, so then, you know, so you need to decide. I mean, since anything, you need to decide, right? So then if you have to kill, you know, the animals, the insects or anything for like the rules or regulations, so then then there is a purification practice. You should do some purification practice afterwards, you know, so do something virtuous act for them. So do something that can benefit all the victims or all these insects or what you have killed.
As opposed to the thinking and planning that goes into it as far as the merit, I was thinking that sometimes the thinking and the planning takes a lot of effort, and the action might be not all that big. So is there considered that an action is more positive than the thinking and wishing and planning that takes lots of time and energy?
Pena namne ra chhe kon chhe shit as tyang ra ta ngara zu ti phege ra chhe na chawe ni disura chhe sem a de pena kulung chue jo ra moran sam chul ta kulung chue de la ya ani tu zu mang bo kor gi du ani sam lo mang bo tang wo du an de la ya shuk shi wo ja wo du an de ko chhe zen de ko chhe zen je ma je ma de la ngun ne khoro chi lang len chi tar du tu zu tyun du ji re sha s tu zu tyun du ji re sha di im ba ina ta lalen tare di dile kulung jue di kechie yena kechie chagi yena nyoba chie yena yang khane ne kulung jue di ne ne ne
khane na wa di shung mang bu di ne na la sung xia di kulung khuran le go tu gu tu je ne ani din de gi che de ne di kulung khuran le go tu ya di kan ji kulung jang ju gu sem se de gu ya de wa jang ju gu sem khuran nyam ne chi ge ya de ti ani gara su gure ngaran zu gi ko ya gu zu ti re ti ar ba ti la le ti ti ne ta ya ti te chi le me ne ku lu ku chan ju gu ku nu chan ju sem ti ta ga ra la sam ta chi ti ar ti ra sam ta chi ti te ga ji gi yu su re ma pe je na li ya re ti ne ku to pa ti chu re to pa tinde che sene kunu khora na go tu tu sene ane ngi shi ti ko tu min tu sene kunu khora na go na ti ge ya res kunu ti chan ju ge sem se sam chan ju ge sem na sam dang ge ba na ju kyo to chi ju che sho ti chan ju ge sem ru
So yes, this is a debate issue. We have raised that kind of questions in Tibet ground, I must say. So then it said that the motivation or the intention takes so long, and you know, all of your time, most of the time you spend on that period of time, sort of like a preparation or motivation and stuff like that. So, but the And according to the scripture or the text, you know, conclusion of the debate, it came to that even though it may take a really long time, so that is necessary, required, and it's worthwhile, and it is a virtuous act.
No. That's okay.
Any questions? Any more questions? Main sir.
Tambore.
Yeah. No questions? Okay.
So we have 30 minutes, right?
23 minutes,
okay. Come on, issues too.
Come on, issues too. Yeah. Тай чи зүгэвцэн гямд симги сет чи ста симги сет чи гямд чи та та цуши сет авс а чожи шивади цуши сет авс сет
але таги жорчу тамбу гямро чи дэнэ симгерве
не тамбу Неганчи то чеши, косунтунги тентам бас. Неба чува юми бе, юми чи, кувензе баршам бас.
Одирва, чува чоту диман.
Сумба тенте вала лутуну кетам, кандири кубикуни, кямди симки чавас. Сумба тирва, шива, сошин
сета бас. Ngaba di?
Ngaba di сачанги нетуба, менте, яла тимбас че. Tupati mente pyushi sundip
chivas.
Sundipas yatiri.
Okay. So, if you have this book, textbook, you can look at page number 29. It listed all the six preliminaries. Cleaning your room and arranging symbols of Buddha's body, speech and mind. Obtaining offering honestly and arranging them beautifully. And sitting in the eightfold meditation posture of Varachana and then taking refuge and generating bodhicitta. So we are here. So far we got here. Now next, visualizing the merit field. And then following is practicing seven limbs prayer, making requests following to all instructions.
This one. The Jamduchis Tigta, so she said of a setting. Other so she said of a tetua Rang Dingi Tetank in Nangains, sing it in Bukay Tibes. Do we? Tens, more rang it in the tone, number Javasha to be. Kundo said some tabus, we two daughter than Bashi Chang. Yanis, Union Shaggit and the Tizigar Nutsenum. Kula Chugum, Monsieur, Sembikim, Kuliki Vivigi, Shammy, Tochi, Kitungi, Shuba, Tas, so did it. Jamdugi, Jamdu to a shintigist, Zodi, Javasha to be.
Yes. So if you look on page number 33, the last paragraph, it says taking refuge, right? From the within that visualization follows, in the space directly in front of me is a high white jewel throne supported by eight great lions, and all the way down to next page, what's the Vajra posture, emit an aura of light. Okay, up to here. So this is a refuge field. Okay, refuge field. The main figure or the main the principal deity or the object in the refuge field is Buddha Shakyamuni.
Oh, then it's so shing to the Shakyamuni Chikuya Dichita Sanji Tembegetapu di Shajatubari Lamri Digi. Any chude kung tu seti Tombe Shajatubu tu kuguyari. Tinsa Kanle chue, chue mambuchi yari de Zawa tal tu seti Tombe Shajatubu tu kuvati Shere chitu tu Rang Lama Imbala, Moti Lama Imbala, Namba Tikawa Shayatubang, Namba Chikoyati, Chu Tigin Junku, Tartu Bati, Tomba Shayatubara, or D in Bashevichetu, and so Tomba Shayatubazul Mayatiris.
So in this meditation session, in the refuge field, so we need to see or take Shakyamuni as the principal deity or figure in that object. So that the Buddha Shakyamuni is the main figure is your teacher. So your teacher, but the teacher appears in the form of Buddha Shakyamuni. Okay, Buddha Shakyamuni. So we select or keep Buddha Shakyamuni as the main figure in this object because it actually shows that all of this practice or instructions, you know, this personal instructions, the Lamrim instruction, this personal, you know, the Lamrim instructions came from Buddha Shakyamuni. So whatever we practice in these following practices is linked back to the Buddha Shakyamuni. The source of these teachings came from the Buddha Shakyamuni. It shows that is the identification why we have Buddha Shakyamuni in the middle of this object refuge.
Oh, that ne, the Tagor to Ueta Kibia Lama, Eatum Sanges, Bo Kandu, then soon she tonum to go as Jay.
So then the following paragraph on page 34, surrounding him is a host of transcendental beings, your direct and lineage gurus, meditation deities, and so on.
Tati tago to Mueta cubes, Mueti lama seti, Tawai lama seti imbre. Ran a chundi musu in yig lama tillet, Mueti lama seti. Cube lama seti, ran a chundi mus major, rangi chundi musu in yetigi. Any tensag lama tillet, lama to see aya jena, as Sanjetus cube lama rigere. Candy.
So then your direct and lineage lamas, gurus. So your direct lama means it will be your the root gurus and lama or the teacher whom you may have received teachings directly from them. Yeah. So then the lineage gurus or lineage teacher, lineage lama is that your lama's lama. So then that can trace all the way back to Buddha Shakyamuni. Buddha Shakyamuni becomes our lineage gurus, lineage lamas. So the lineage, so these instructions, whatever instructions, these instructions coming came from all these lineage lamas.
Oh, that ngi lama dile ani kadisumdegi lama siyaji. Zawe lama dile ya ani kadisumdegi lama, kadinindegi lama, kadin otindegi lama mambu yare. Kadisumdegi sena pina onkur. Nalajena onkur ni san gyusung ni ongu gyusi mengana wa sum chungsu na sungga chungsu na kadisum den sigre dojo jena kati sumde ki tsala masayati tomba bau tine doshe mega nanye tiyarba doyu tenshe tine chi mega nanye tiyarba tila dojo jena kati sumde sikari ta tine mebe che chwe ra janja che tomba mana na kati nyindi riba tine shi nga choli na onku gyu da menga riba tine mashebe yena ta kati jindi riba ya gyu she gyu gu tunda she on ma gu batinde yena kati sumde rigi amari cha sa kati sumde seyati la kati sumde tsawa nama seyati tindi chiya resi.
So the your direct guru or root gurus is something that you have received teachings directly from them. So then the within the root gurus there are some root gurus may have some root gurus may have extend three kindness or two kindness, one type of kindness, you can say. So the three kindness is according to Vajrayana tradition. So three kindness refers to someone who gives initiations and explains the tantric texts and the meaning of the tantric texts, teaching commentary on tantric texts, and the someone who gives. The personal instructions. So if you have that, so you have received all of them from one individual lama, you can consider that lama has been extending you three types of kindness. And then some lama may have give you initiation, but not the other two. That you can consider that is you have received one kindness from that lama, or two or one. So you can go for that then according to what you have received from that individual. And then the according to Sutrayana, so there's two types of kindness refers to someone who gives you vows. Okay, vows. There are different types of vows. So vows, and someone who explains and explain or teaches on sutras, Buddha sutras, and also someone who gives you this personal instructions and realizations. So then if you have received all this, you can consider that as your Sutrayana, the root lama, someone who has give you who has been given you three kindness, you can say.
That good no to give lama stine idams idam gudishiyari sangye sindu sangye tongzani sangye sumjusona melati shikela suba sangye.
So then they are surrounded by meditational deity. Meditation deities includes deities from four tantric classes. And the Buddhas from thousands Buddhas and 37 confession Buddhas and all those Buddhas surrounded to the main guru.
Oh, then is Jansim said this. Jansim nyewe se jinkele sube.
So then the next Bodhisattva. So Bodhisattva includes close eight Bodhisattvas and all the other Bodhisattvas, limitless Bodhisattvas.
Then pa bau kandro seti bau kandro seti shingi ngaji nengi ge ponya seti shingi ge kandro mas nyeti ngaji ge kandro mas yeti. Ani lengi ke kandro masinya yare kandro mambo shingi ke kandro masaya di yu yin shu tsepsi na yuwe bau kandro to su che lengi ke su wumi na yuwe ani kandro ma to su che ngeke se de ani legi onki ke shiwe kandro ma odinde yare isa.
So then next, surrounded by heroes, heroines, dakas and dakinis. Sometimes they say dakas and dakinis. So then there are three types of dakas and dakinis. the field born dakinis, dakas and dakinis, and womb born dakas and dakinis, and innate born dakas and dakinis. So the field born dakas and dakinis refers to someone who has take rebirth in the places, 24 places, dakas and dakinis places. And then the womb birth, dakas and dakinis refers to who take rebirth due to the karma, okay, karma, karmically reborn dakas and dakinis. And then the link innate dakas and dakinis, innate born dakas and dakinis refers to dakas and dakinis in Sukhavati pure land.
Then so you see it, Senna, and then you tell it, Debe Summa, so soon, then but soon you see it, so said you see it, Summa. Carzure. Jidele deve summatusu, tene, sochinal, cochuvi, jidembe summatusu, sochinal, quickum ever. What did sochinal unity? A tensu in shigitso, said.
So the next is an assembly of Dharma protectors. So, Dharma protector, there are two types of Dharma protectors. So one Dharma protector is called wisdom Dharma protectors, and another one, and you can say the super mundane Dharma protector and the mundane Dharma protectors. So so the mundane Dharma protectors are not allowed to be on the refuge field. Okay, so whatever Dharma protectors on that refuge field has to be super mundane Dharma protectors.
Oh, tene lama ngi ji lama yidam sangye tige di sangye kunjo se atiri di endi sangye kunjo se ati.
Ale, that kunjo sumla ma goe bai na ro. So if you categorize all these beings in the refuge field into three objects of refuge, so then the your direct lamas, lineage gurus, direct gurus and lineage gurus, meditation deities, Buddhas, all the way up to here is yes, meditation deity and Buddhas are the what you call them, Buddha refuge.
Dene jansim bo kandu tensu.
So the rest of the Buddha, Bodhisattvas, heroes, heroines, or Buddhakas and Dakinis, and assembly of Dharma protectors are this. You can categorize them in a Sangha, Sangha refuge, object of Sangha refuge.
That did that Rarang Duna Tinti Pusu Tobala Rarang Sumbi Nungi Chuinum Buddhi Namba Jengi. But the number you was, or that he chuck on Joe Setti, and he rarang duna, lama yetam, sanjeti rarang duna, chuputi, yerba, DJ, and it a chancin po candles, tigig duna, rarang sumbe lungi chuti, put the number you was yerba, did chuck on Joe Setti, did.
So then the Dharma, the object of Dharma refuge would be, if you read from that line, it said, in front of each of them of a marvelous throne sits the Dharma explained by them in the form of text made of light. So that will, so their own teachings, so whatever they have given teachings, all these teachings in appears in the form of Dharma text and sit right next to them, each of them. So that will represents the object of the Dharma refuge.
That is in a teacher. That in a come to chair. And it's washing to soup. Soshin and Jarangi gave it to Sita. Soshin and Jarala gave it to the watching book be sitting here. Rangi Jan, Soshin and Gin de Timber Kune. 초신기 도배인데 룽기인데 다 연대파도 매버야리 캠베인데야리 두수기인데 두수템바다 오늘 두지템바스 상게 초신음 니 라운드 두지남라 저 저 두지 침부터 덴바르 봐 제서 두지 덴베스 두지 침부고 이 덴베코네 대바 침부 안에 디다르삼스 다디 아니 주신들게 세 탑자스나 되네 초신도 수 라니르 메게바 마인바 게베 주진 라니가 초신기 윤대다 두지 덴베코네 대바
So then the text goes on, the member of the merit field are in the aspect of being pleased with me by remembering their qualities. Okay, then remember, so the being and the objects of merit field is pleased with we us. So then they should be like really you should imagine that kind of pleased with you. So then they by remembering their qualities, the remembering their qualities means as a practitioner, so yourself, so we should understand understand their qualities. We need to understand their qualities. So their qualities would be like qualities of their realizations, their realizations, and quality of their teachings, and quality of their divine the omniscience, and then the quality of abandonment and so on. So we need to understand that we need to realize their qualities and also their kindness. So kindness. So then I feel great devotion to them by having understanding on these qualities and their kindness. So then we should develop a strong devotion to them.
Yeah.
Hope so we will end here.